I've tried to standardize all my quick-release plates to the Arca Swiss type plates. I purchased many for various projects and have looked on Thingiverse for a model that I could print with my 3D printer. I didn't find any that fit my needs, so I designed my own. I've used this design for several projects, like my rotate, tilt, time-lapse platform, my macro focus rail, and to adapt my old Manfrotto quick-release plates to the Arca-compatible plates. The design was done in SketchUp, and I have provided a link in my text to my website for download of the design, photos, STL files for printing, and text instructions. If you don't have a 3D printer, you may get a friend to print the parts, or you may have access to a 3D printer at a library or hobby center. Our library has a makerspace center where 3D printers are available. I've used PLA and PETG filament for printing on a Monoprice Select Mini, and both types worked well. When the parts have been printed, the holes in the jaw and knob may require a little cleaning. I used a 9/64 drill bit in a chuck and turn it by hand to clean the holes. Don't clean the hole in the base, since it is designed to be tight, so when the 6/32 machine screw is screwed in, it will create tight threads that will hold the screw when the knob is rotated. To assemble the parts, start with the knob. Insert a 6/32 machine screw from the end with the small hole. The screw should slide through easily. Screw the nut onto the screw until it is flush with the hex hole and align it with the hex hole, and turn the screw with the screwdriver pulling the nut into the hex recess until it is snug at the bottom of the recess. Unscrew the machine screw and screw it into the nut through the hex recess, and continue turning the screw until it is flush with the end of the knob with the small hole. Slide the knob into the dovetail-like slot in the jaw, aligning the screw with the hole in the jaw. Screw the machine screw through the jaw until it is about 1/8 of an inch out of the jaw. Position the jaw into the base and use a screwdriver to screw the machine screw into the hole in the base until the screw shows through the hole for the T-nut in the base. Back the screw out until it is just flush with the edge of the T-nut hole. Insert the T-nut into the hole, aligning the points with the three holes around the recess for the T-nut. Use a 1/4-20 machine screw to pull the T-nut tightly into the recess. You can now use the knob to open and close the jaw for the quick release plate. Don't over-tighten the jaw, since you might strip the threads created in the base when you screwed in the 6/32 machine screw. It doesn't take much pressure to hold the plate firmly. To fasten the plate to a camera or other device, use a pre-made screw, available at Amazon, or modify a 1/4-20 machine screw. I mount a 1-inch or longer 1/4-20 machine screw in my drill press or electric drill. Rotating at fairly slow speed, I use a file to remove about 3/16 of an inch, or 5 millimeters, of threads, making a narrow part of the shaft that will be loose in the plate hole when it is screwed in. This will keep the screw in the hole when it is unscrewed from the camera. I then put washers and a nut on the screw to a length of about 3/8 of an inch, or 10 millimeters, and cut the screw to that length. I use a Dremel tool, but a hacksaw will work too. File and sand the end smooth, slightly rounding the tip to remove any burrs. Remove the nut and washers, and then put the nut back on and tighten to be sure all threads are clean, and remove the nut. Screw the machine screw through the hole in the plate, and be sure that only 3/16 or 5 millimeters sticks out of the plate. Be sure your camera or other device has more than 5 millimeters of depth into which the screw goes before tightening too much. File the screw shorter if it is too long to prevent damage to your equipment. If you have very small cameras, you can modify the plate to fit with Sketchup. For this Panasonic point-and-shoot camera, I shortened the plate so it wouldn't stick out too much past the side of the camera. I hope this video has been informative. Thank you for viewing.